Hey, nice to meet you.
Hey, I'm Willow. Will-
My name's Peter. My friends call me Pete.
Alley hoop.
What's the worst thing that could happen?
Ready for adventure.
Sponsor. Kids, are you ready for a new wild and wacky Puncho fruit flavor? Introducing Apricot. It's a punch to the gut.
So stop by, fill up, and make sure you get your Billy Hog hot dog before you jet away.
Good morning, Brook Hollow. Today is October 20, 1990. This is your news. We have a special breaking report. The police department has released information that more local teenagers have gone missing. They were last seen earlier this week, and the only connection between the teenagers is that they are all students at Brook Hollow High School. This could be linked to the disturbing trend of other possible abductions and missing teenagers from our otherwise quiet town. If anyone has seen the teenagers or has any other information, please contact the police department. The mayor of Brook Hollow has put a curfew into effect for anyone under 18 starting tonight. Now to other news. In the business world, prominent practical technology signs a few deals with.
Oh, Pete. Oh, looks like you really stepped in it this time. Just where in the world are you? Hello? Hello? All right, Pete. Remember your scout training. Step one, get your bearings.
Signal detected.
What's that? Sounds like a radio signal. It must be being transmitted from nearby. Taking a look. Well, logic dictates that there are probably more of these stations around. Maybe if I keep searching, I'll find some clues. Or someone.
Science!
Curious. Avadoidia. Worse than my mom's Brussels sprouts. Consulting Detective Weevil, hot on the trail. He's got a nose for the truth.
Science!
I'm not sure if holding my hands to my face makes me see any better than with my glasses.
Thank you.
Science!
Hark, yonder lady of the Clover Forest! On what errand does the day find you?
Thank you.
Better than starving, I think. Of that thing. It's probably the size of a bathroom scale?
I was a fool to have ever doubted myself. A fool like Klein, like Kamensky, like Schmechter, like all of Ominent.
It looks like this thing hooks up with those lasers. I don't think that worked properly. It seems like the machine needs all three lasers to function. Maybe there's a way to fix them? Filtration tablets needed. Hey, a common example of the Firmicidae family. Choke it down, Pete. Wow, look at the size of that Chunky Chubb's league-approved baseball. It's the size of my dang house. It's getting quite late. I should construct some shelter and get some sleep. Whoa, why don't you just stay over there, small red insect? Nose. Better than starving, I think. Mm-hmm. Would you look at that? It's super infected.
Science!
A firefly. Nature's lantern.
Science!
Nice and clean.
Science!
Don't even need to boil it.
Choke it down, Pete.
Science!
Thank you.
Science!
Nice and clean. You
science.
I feel a little less squishy now.
Mm-hmm.
Water filtration tablets needed. Ugh. Worse than my mom's Brussels sprouts. Let there be light! tremor detected. Something's afoot.
Scabby, additional flavor scheme available.
Choke it down, Pete.
Science!
Keep me safe. Safer.
Thank you.
Raw science!
Salt.
My bad?
Science!
Aphids, nature's lollipops. Thank you. By the power of Helion, champion of the sun! A little chewy, but not bad. Thank you. Don't even need to boil it. Taking a look. Got one! Ant crossing. No water filtration tablets needed. Taking a look. Map marker placed. Yeah. Mark that one off the list. Shelob's ghost! Taking a look. Right here. Thank you. those look like idealized geometric shapes in that pink thing. They can't be real. Just pretend it's beef jerky.
I have isolated the source of the particle irregularities. They appear to be a byproduct of the shrinking process. If I adjust the machine to account for their existence, it should be the key to the de-shrinking, expanding process. Burgle, please bring up the readings for the irregular covalent SNPI-42Z particle traces. Ugh, that name is going to get tiresome. And while you're at it, rename all references to the irregular covalent SMPI-42Z particle to Raw Science.
Order received. Raw Science identified. Does it require cooking, flipping, or grilling?
No, none of those. Categorization.
That answer is not permitted, according to health code standards governing the handling of raw food items.
Let me try to help.
System reboot in progress. Thanks for the helping hand. I am Burgle, acting science manager for this project. I am also a robot. I am sure this all must be very disorienting for you, but hopefully I can explain. I suspect you were miniaturized by Dr. Tully's spacer device. Why are you here in the yard? I do not know. In fact, I cannot seem to recall much of anything. A recent power surge has caused a massive raw science containment explosion. This lab, as you can see, is a disaster. And what's worse, the explosion has disrupted my computing power. My memory banks are corrupted. Sorry to pile on the bad news, my new friend. How can I be of service? It seems you and I are both a little discombobulated. Given my best calculations, your biomass has been subject to covalent spacing reduction via interatomic energy extraction. In other words, you have been shrunk. It is likely this was achieved using Dr. Wendell Tully's Spacer platform, patent pending. Shrinking can be a traumatic experience for tiny human brains, and memory loss is a known side effect. Hopefully, your memory will return in time.
Science.
One success after another! I have returned Burgle to his original size! It appears that my new raw science containment field is working at 99% effectiveness.
98.5%.
Right, Burgle, right. However, as Burgle indicates, there is some minor insignificant raw science leakage. A note for another time.
Noted.
But I see no reason to put off a human trial. I believe there should be no issues. But, audentes fortuna juvat. I am ready to prove my creation's full potential. End recording. Burgle, I'd like to record some messages for my family, in case things do not go as planned.
Better than starving, I think.
I am sure this all must be very... I suspect you were... Why are you here in the yard? I do not... A recent... And what's worth... Sorry to... Dr. Tully is a brilliant scientist and inventor. He is also my creator. My initial protocol was to serve as the short-order cook of the future. However, I have been recently promoted to acting science manager to assist with his experiments. No doubt my previous work experience has been invaluable to Dr. Tully. Although, now that I am processing it, I have not seen him for several weeks. And now I cannot recall where he went. It must be my corrupted memory banks. You are here, in the Oak Lab, built and used by Dr. Wendell Tully to experiment on all things small. This is the base of operations for conducting experiments in his yard. To return to your prior size, you would need to successfully activate Dr. Tully's spacer platform. Unfortunately, my readings indicate it is inoperable. It appears to have suffered several malfunctions from the explosion. I am sorry, but it appears you may be stranded here for some time until we find a solution. Haha! That is a great idea! Let me run a full diagnostic scan on it and see what we need to do to get it fixed up. Processing! Processing! Memory fault. Code 408B3000. Imminent OS script runtime error. Arg! I am sorry again. It appears I have sustained more damage to my memory chips than expected. Without those memories, I do not know how to repair the spacer. Dr. Tully used two types of chips to back up my memory. Auxiliary chips are small capacity chips used to store project data. If you find these, I should be able to help you learn new survival recipes. Super chips are special, and they are gold! They back up full directories of my memory system. If we are going to fix the spacer, that data is bound to be on a super chip. I suggest exploring the other labs in the backyard. Return with any memory chips you find. Dr. Tully has built many more labs throughout the yard. Each lab is used for various experimental procedures. I can upload their locations to your scabby. Stand by. Processing. Processing. Error. Files not found. Code 632C404. Cheese and fries! The lab locations are missing from my memory banks too! But we are in luck. I was able to retrieve the location of one of the facilities, the Hedge Lab. The Hedge Lab is the observation center of the yard and used for research on arachnid webbing. You will find the hedge near the house if you head southeast. The lab is located deep inside the hedge, sending the coordinates to your scabby. Try to find the Hedge Lab first, but there is nothing stopping you from searching the yard for the other labs. Except, of course, thousands of angry, hungry insects. That reminds me, Dr. Tully locks the important labs with biometric scanners. You will need access for any chance of success. Head over to the ASL terminal and place your hand on the biometric scanner near it. Give it a moment to sync your signature into the mainframe. Once you are registered, you will be granted access to the ASL network of computers too. ASL grants access to daily work items, nay, tasks, nay, quests. Yes, quests. I will reward you raw science for each completed quest. In my science shop, you can trade raw science back for survival recipes from experiments that Wendell conducted when he was first exploring the yard. Log on to the ASL terminal over there and see what is available. Unless you have any other questions, you really should get started finding those chips and try not to die out there. Have an exponentially great day!
Worse than my mom's Brussels sprouts.
Leave that. would Dr. Tikitoni do?
Scientific breakthrough.
This morning, I installed the borrowed lab modules, another one of my forgotten inventions from the early days. I had such grand notions back then. The Kinder Science Mini Quick Little Chemist Lab educational toy for children. But no, Wendell, we can't possibly put hydrochloric acid into the hands of children. The lawyers will never agree. It's a good thing I never told them about the Bunsen burners. Odd that Ominent has been using my toy pieces in this way. I digress. The lab network is now up and running in the backyard. I'm planning to dedicate each one of them to a different function. Main power will run through here, the Oak Lab, as the center of operations for the backyard. The second lab is nestled into the hedge. Such wonderful views from up there. Side note, I'm worried that Ominent's shoddy manufacturing of the lab pieces will cause them to fall apart over time, but they will do for now.
Verbal transcription unit 87.9.5. Order number one.
Robot, I need you to monitor these power fluctuations and inform me if they exceed acceptable limits.
Hello, my name is Verbal, and I will be serving you today. I specialize in cooking, flipping, and grilling.
Grilling? A feature useful only to your obsolete burger-flipping brethren now consigned to the scrap heap? I need you to monitor these readings, Burgle. And isn't it redundant to specialize in cooking and grilling?
Understood. Appending monitor power fluctuations to my prime directive list, deprioritizing grilling.
Good. Now get on with it.
Reprioritizing grilling.
Got one! That's a soldier. I can't really tell the difference from here. place. Tiny Pete needs food badly. Better than starving, I think. Tiny Pete needs food badly. Tiny Pete needs food badly.
Transcription unit 87.9.5. Order number 1.
Robot, I need you to monitor these power fluctuations and inform me if they exceed acceptable limits.
Hello, my name is Gurgle, and I will be serving you today. I specialize in cooking, flipping, and grilling.
Grilling? A feature useful only to your obsolete burger flipping brethren now consigned to the scrap heap. I need you to monitor these readings. Burgle. And isn't it redundant to specialize in...
fluctuations to my prime directive list. Deprioritizing grilling.
I could use something to drink.
Burgle Transcription Unit 87.9.5. Order number 1.
Robot, I need you to monitor these power fluctuations and inform me if they exceed acceptable limits.
Hello! My name is Burgle, and I will be serving you today. I specialize in cooking, flipping, and grilling.
Grilling? A feature useful only to your obsolete burger-flipping brethren now consigned to the scrap heap? I need you to monitor these readings, Burgle. And isn't it redundant to specialize in cooking and grilling?
Understood. Appending monitor power fluctuations to my prime directive list. Deprioritizing grilling.
Good. Now get on with it.
Reprioritizing grilling.
Nice and clean. I spy. Worse than my mom's Brussels sprouts. My mom always says I light up a room. I could keep that aphid as a pet. That is a big spider. I don't think I'm high enough level to take on such a foe. Hey, Fid. Hey, Fid. Good run. wonder if it's my turn next on the side of the squirt's milk carton. Oh no! What if my mom uses my 7th grade yearbook photo? Maybe I'm better off trapped down here. I spy. New one for the bestiary. Location marked. Bombardier Beetle, put on your peepers. Mark that one off the list. Map marker placed. nice and clean. Taking a look. Thank you. taking a look. The battle begins!
Science.
I spy... I could use something to drink. Water filtration tablets needed. Taking a look. New one for the bestiary. I'm trapped!
Science!
Verbal Transcription Unit 89.10.5, order number 20.
Burgle, did you organize my research notes on the material properties of the hedge berries as I directed?
Of course. Well, no.
Good. Wait. Explain.
I have logged 110,437 different algorithms for organization and compiled them into an alphabetical list. That menu is being printed now and should be ready for review in approximately 12 weeks. After that is complete, I will be able to organize your research notes based on the algorithm you select.
Well, let me know when it's...
Taking a look. New one for the bestiary. Yeah.
Science!
Verbal Transcription Unit 89.10.5. Order number 20.
Burgle, did you organize my research notes on the material properties of the hemispheres as I directed?
Of course. Well, no.
Good. Wait. Explain.
I have logged 110,437 different algorithms for organization and compiled them into an alphabetical list. That menu is being printed now and should be ready for review in approximately 12 weeks. After that is complete, I will be able to organize your research notes based on the algorithm you select.
Well, let me know when it's done then.
Mark that one off the list. Better than starving, I think. Where there's one Spiderling, there's bound to be more of them.
Mm-hmm.